Hey guys, and welcome to another iWorkGamer tutorial. Today I will be teaching you guys how to make an iPod style wallpaper or an iPod commercial style wallpaper. It'll look something like this. iScooby. I guess it looks kind of cool. You'll be making the iPod a silhouette of your character. You can use any character. So this is actually a remaster of my earlier one because I had to private because of information showing in that video. So let's get on to the tutorial. First, you're going to make sure this image is a PNG, which means you have no white and it is transparent background of your character. It doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to be pretty close to perfect. So I'm going to do this, I'm going to drag it in, convert the colors. And I'm just going to open a selection, but you could go File, Open as Layers, and go to your desktop and grab that. Now you're going to go File, New, and make the image the size of your desktop wallpaper, or you could use whatever you want for ads or whatever. Now that you've got this, you're going to select a color that you want for your background. I'm going to select green. I don't know why, but I like the color green. Let's use that. Just fill that in. And now that you have your silhouette copied, or your character copied, after you have that copied, you can just go edit, paste, and it's done. You can make that floating selection a normal layer. Move it around to where you want it to go. Now you're gonna alpha selection that pasted layer again. Grab your bucket tool. Fill it in with black. Change the foreground color to black. And select fill whole selection. And just fill everything in. Select none. Now that you have your silhouette done, it's time to make your iPod. You're gonna make a new layer. And you're gonna zoom in. More than that. And you're gonna make your iPod with the rectangle select tool. And it's just gonna be a classic iPod because you want it to be white and to match the wallpaper, I guess you could say. So we're just gonna make the rounded corners. About 5. Grab your bucket tool and fill it in with white. Grab a rectangle select tool again, and you're gonna turn off the rounded corners because this is a screen, something like that. You're gonna fill that one in with black, select none, and here's where you make the spin or click wheel or whatever you want to call it, spin circle. Whatever. I'm just gonna make a circle. Fill it in with gray. Very light gray, of course. Select none. Grab your ellipse select tool again. Just make a smaller circle. Just put it in the middle of that circle. And fill this one in with white. You're basically done your iPod, but first, so that we'll know where to select, you're gonna add on the base of the headphones, and that's just gonna fill in with white. Select none. Now, of course, it doesn't look like an iPod with the little thing sticking out, but it's okay. Now you're gonna rotate it to how much you would like to rotate it. I'll rotate it about that much. And zoom back out. Move your iPod to where your character will be holding it. And here's the, I guess you could say, hardest part of it. Grab your path select tool and just click right inside of that, and just click a few times like this. Click up here, go back here, click up here, and click back down here. Now you're gonna mess around with these paths. You're gonna curve them all to the side with that. Even though it's gonna look stupid, I'll show you how to fix this. These little squares right here, these are what's gonna fix that. So you can mess around with those. Until you have it perfect. And don't worry about these little sharp corners here. We're gonna change those later. So now that you've got this cord done, you're gonna go stroke path. And you're just gonna stroke it with a stroke the line. For me, I'm just gonna do it 3 pixels. Or you could use this paint tool to check what you have earlier. Stroke. So now it's gonna look something like this. And here's where you're gonna fix up those little imperfections around here. I'm gonna zoom in. Just find anywhere where there's like a straight bend in the cord. Look right there. Alright, about that much. Grab your path select tool. Select from here to here. And bend the corner. So, and now your stroke path. 3 pixels, stroke. So now that it looks almost perfect, you're gonna add a phrase. After you zoom out, of course. You're gonna add a phrase. On another new layer. Show you how to do something like that. And this is gonna say, whatever, I'm gonna say, I do. Or whatever. I Scooby. Like I said before. And the font you're gonna want is Myriad Pro Semi Bold. Mostly gonna cost something. But I have it on my Mac, so it's free. Myriad Pro Semi Bold. And you can turn up the size. Something that looks right. And you can change the spacing. Move it around. And that's done with the text. So now you could do this before. You could do this before you make the text. But I'm just gonna do it after. So you're gonna grab your paintbrush tool and just kind of, that might look a bit good. So you're gonna take your paintbrush tool, select a size, and then you're gonna check it on the background to check how big it is. So let's zoom back in and just click at the end of this. Grab your paintbrush tool again and make it quite a bit smaller. Then you're just gonna stroke a bit wider around the base of the cord and the earbud. So now that you're done with that part, here's where we're gonna perfect and finish it. You're gonna tone up the size of your tool or whatever you're using, paintbrush tool, whatever. And you're just gonna erase this wire that's in here. About perfection. Now you're gonna select your path tool again and just select right here and slip like that. Now you're gonna stroke path again, 3 pixels, and you're done. You can go, or you don't have to go select none because it's no selection, and you can just zoom back out to your size and see your finished product, apply, and you're done. So that's how to make an iPod commercial style wallpaper. See you guys next time, and bye-bye.